Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
As the scientific community struggles hard day and night to develop both a vaccine and a drug to treat COVID-19, results of such trials abound for everyone to see, leading to plenty of confusion. To understand how to interpret studies and trials, let's break down some medical jargon which are important to understand these results. First, let's look at drugs. Drugs are substances that can treat a disease. For COVID-19, drugs can't cure the virus. In fact, to date, we don't have any substances that can kill viruses in our bodies like antibiotics do for bacteria. So we have no cure for viruses, and we aren't likely to get one for SARS-CoV-2 either. But we do use drugs to reduce the viral load or the numerical quantity of virus in a given sample of body fluid. Drugs do so by inhibiting the mechanism with which a virus replicates. In fact, antibodies produced by our own body work in a similar manner as well, by decreasing the replication of virus. Sometimes viruses can also be inactivated by tampering with their fat coating or outer lipid layer, such as when washing hands with soap, and this simply prevents the virus from being able to infect but does not kill it. To develop drugs and vaccines, we need medical trials and studies. The gold standard for a study is double-blinded randomized control. In fact, randomizing, controlling, and blinding are the three most important factors in establishing cause and effect in trials for drugs. Randomization is the process of allocating people to different groups at random, and then each group receiving different treatments before their results are compared with each other. This is to prevent biases in data stemming from other factors such as differences in sex, age, socioeconomic status, pre-existing conditions, etc. Thus, this results in each group having a relatively good mix of all these parameters. It's never perfect enough to be homogeneous, but it reduces the chances that one group is substantially different from another, such as a high incidence of diabetes in one group versus the others. These groups are then given different types of treatment. One group could be given the drug that is being tested, another one given a placebo, and yet another group being given the control. The control is what we already understand. For most existing diseases, the control is typically a drug whose effects on the body we're already familiar with. For newer disease and for COVID-19 trials, typically the control is standard care, which is the usual care of isolation, quarantine, ventilators, oxygen, etc., without any drugs. Results from these groups are compared against each other and against the control group to establish if the drug works. Now, blinding is the process by which the subject does not know whether they are being given a drug or a placebo. Double blinding is when the administrator or the doctor themselves don't know what they're administering is a drug or a placebo. This also reduces bias in data, and if everyone knows exactly what they're getting, it's called an open label trial. COVID-19 drug trials fall across the spectrum here. Now, trials also occur in different phases. Preclinical studies, they don't involve humans and show results in the lab, either in vitro in petri dishes or in vivo in animals. An optional phase 0 involves about 10 people, but most studies skip this phase directly to enter phase 1, where 20 to about 100 people are used in trials. This phase is used to establish that a drug is safe for further trials. Phase 2 trials involve up to 300 patients and is a preliminary test to see if the safe drug is also efficient. Once the drug shows some promise, a phase 3 trial is launched on up to 3,000 patients to see how effective a drug is. Due to the expedited nature of COVID-19 research, most drug trials have skipped the first two phases and then gone on directly to phase 3, experimenting on humans. Later, phase 4 arrives, where there is only observation for long-term effects in the approved drug that is already being sold on the market. Clinical studies are broadly of two types: trials, where there's medical intervention to treat a disease, such as blinded randomized trials, and observational studies, where there is no intervention and the results of a drug are simply observed to find patterns. Administering hydroxychloroquine to Indian healthcare workers, for example, is an observational study, as it is prescribed indiscriminately to all healthcare workers. The results are not compared with a control, which should ideally be another group of of randomized healthcare workers who have equal exposure to the disease and have not taken HCQ. It is also an observational cohort study where the cohort or group of people who make up the test subjects are followed up with until a desired result can be either confirmed or rejected. Trials and studies are validated and published after the peer review process, where other peers in the field who are unaffiliated with the study comb through it in great detail to ensure that it is rigorous. In times of COVID-19, though, what we tend to see are preprints which are uploaded to servers. Preprints are early papers that are submitted online but have not yet undergone the peer review process and have not been published. As a result, a lot of badly done trials full of biases tend to become equally as visible as the good ones. Assessing preprints requires extreme care and diligence to prevent the risk of scientific miscommunication during times of a pandemic. This is Sandhya Ramesh in Bengaluru for The Print.